to week three of the fantasy football season. He has a few defenses I would look to add this week. The first one's the Carolina Panthers. So the Panthers here in week two, very surprising ball game versus the New Orleans Saints. And their defense went out there and they had a hell of a fantasy day. Only 7 points allowed, 4 sacks, 2 interceptions. And they got to Jameis Winston. They made him uncomfortable in the pocket. And the first 2 weeks of the season here, they've been a good fantasy defense. And then this is week, they should be one of the top ads with a slam dunk matchup versus the Houston Texans in week three. And this ball game is not going to have Tyrod Taylor already. They ruled him out with the hamstring injury. And right here, this Panther defense, I could see a ball game where they might score multiple touchdowns in this one at Houston. It's a Thursday night game. And this defense is feeling confident coming off of 2 double-digit fantasy days the first 2 weeks of the season versus the Jets and New Orleans, even though those games were at home for Carolina. But here in week three at Houston, I think they're going to make some noise and make some plays here, especially with the quick turnaround and no Tyrod Taylor. And right now they are available in a whopping 81% of fantasy leagues. The next defense I've looked at on waivers this week here is the Chicago Bears. So the Bears in week two, they made some noise and they had a big ball game, including 3 interceptions and finding the end zone here versus Joe Burrow. 17 points allowed, 4 sacks, 3 inthos, a fumble recovery touchdown in this one. So right here, the Bears, they had them as a sleeper last week in an ad, and it worked out for them. And now in week three, they got a pretty decent matchup, in my opinion, at the Cleveland Browns. Jarvis Landry got hurt in this game. Odell Beckham, so far, he hasn't played in the first 2 games of the season here. Baker Mayfield, he's looked mediocre with those top 2 weapons now. I know Nick Chubb and Kareem Hunt have played good football, but right here, this Bear team, we know they could get to the quarterback. We know they can make some playmaking plays. And I think here in week three at Cleveland, they can make a few plays once again in this game. And they can hold down that offense a little. And right now, they are available in 72% of fantasy leagues at the Chicago Bear defense. The next defense is the Las Vegas Raiders. So the Raiders defense, I know they haven't been great so far this year, but right here in week three, it's going to be a match based on pickup. Tua Tagovailoa, he got hurt in week three with a rib injury, and we don't know how serious it's going to be. But this Miami Dolphin offense so far in the first 2 weeks of the season have only scored 17 points, including getting shut out the other night versus the Buffalo Bills in week two. And here in week three, this Raider defense, I think they can make plays versus Miami, regardless if Tua is starting or not, because I don't think Tua right now is to the level where people want to see him, and I don't think he's that good of a quarterback yet in this league. So week one versus Baltimore, they had 9 fantasy points. And week two with a good Pittsburgh Steeler offense, they had 2 sacks, only 17 points allowed, and an interception. So here in week three, this Raider defense I like as a one-time only pickup versus Miami, and they are available in 98% of fantasy leagues. The next defense I would look to pick up this week is the New York Giants. So the Giants, they didn't have a great outing, obviously, in week two versus the Washington football team. But right here, they're another defense that it's just, I'm going to go off a matchup based here. The Atlanta Falcons, who yesterday we saw this Tampa Bay defense have a huge game, including 2 touchdowns in this one versus Matt Ryan. And this pretty weak Atlanta Falcon offense, to be honest, in the first couple weeks of the season, they've been turnover machine, and they've scored so far only 34 points in the first 2 games. So like I mentioned, this Giant defense, they've been getting torched the first 2 games. But right here, 1 week only thing there. It's a home game in the Meadowlands. The Falcons and Matt Ryan throughout his career haven't played well on the road. We saw it yesterday, and I think we could see it again once again here in week three for Ryan in this offense. And right now, this Giant defense is available in 93% of fantasy leagues. And the fifth and final defense, I look to give an ad on the waiver wire this week, the Minnesota Vikings. So the Vikings, I know they've given up a lot of points, but this defense, they're still going out there and making some playmaking plays for fantasy football. I know yesterday they gave up 34 points, but they still had 3 sacks, 2 interceptions, including a pick six in that ball game. And in week one in Cincinnati, they had 5 sacks in that game. They did give up 27 points. And here week three versus the Seattle Seahawks team, I know it's going to be a shootout. I know they're going to give up a lot of points, but I still think this Viking team, they're going to make teams make some mistakes, and they possibly could find the end zone in this game. And right now they're rolling too. They had a lot of guys out in week two on defense. Week three, hopefully Kendricks and obviously Everson Griffin return to the lineup versus Seattle. But right now I just think this Minnesota Viking team, they still have playmakers. They still could get to the quarterback. And I think here in week three, they could be a decent end. And they're available right now in 82% of fantasy leagues. So that's a few defenses I've looked ahead on waivers heading into week three of the fantasy football season.